Isn't it? This one strand of hair is bothering me since you're like, oh my god, just go away. Dude, why am I so overexposed? Hi, what's up everyone? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to the final rundown of 2020. This is the final four rundown videos. The worst of skincare, the worst of makeup, the best of skincare and the best of makeup. I do this every year where I just, you know, summarize the entire year and give you all the best and worst products that we had this year from everything that I tried. And oh my god, there has been some skincare that really disappointed me this year, and especially when it's with skin, you know, I have tried this on my skin and it hurts to another level when it disappoints. So I'm sharing with you all the worst skincare of 2020 for me. Just giving a disclaimer right here, I think I should, before every one of my disappointing videos, that just because these did not work out for me does not mean that they did not work for you. If they worked for you, well and good, very good. In fact, ki tumhara paisa vasool hua, mera nahi hua, isliye I am here sitting, sharing with you all and telling you all my experience. So if you're interested to know which products disappointed me this year, then keep on watching. But if this is the first time you've come onto my channel, then hi, I'm Sarah. I make beauty and lifestyle content here on YouTube. Try to keep my content very honest and relatable. So if this is the first time you've come here, hit the subscribe button and join the Sarah squad. And also don't forget to click the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. This is skincare and hair care. By the way, I've been saying skincare, but skincare and hair care together. So in no particular order, let's go brand wise. I don't have anything against the brand, just let me tell you all. In fact, there are some of my favorite brands over here. These are just products, like just these particular products did not work for me. So in fact, the first product I'm going to say is from Dr. Shades itself. You all know how much I love Dr. Shades products. They are absolutely amazing. All of Dr. Shades products are really well formulated and particularly suit my skin really, really well. But this particular product, I was a little confused about. I did not know what I'm supposed to do with this. Like, it says it's an on-the-go cleansing spray, and according to the ingredients, it has hyaluronic acid, rose extract and chamomile extract. So I mean, seeing the hyaluronic acid and the rose extract, I thought it was like the Kama Ayurveda rose spray where I just spritz it and like move on with my day. And it also says in the directions that you just spray it on your skin and don't wash it off, you know. But I mean, if you spray this, okay, let me show you here. It does like foam up a little bit, like it has a little bit of an oily texture, and because of maybe of the hyaluronic acid in it, or I don't know what in it, it smells like rose water and it smells like almost absolutely nothing. Maybe the chamomile or the hyaluronic acid is a little too emollient for me. Like the rose water from Kama Ayurveda is really watery, like it absorbs into your skin and does not feel like anything. But this feels a little chip, and I don't like the feeling of it. And then again, the name is a little confusing. Like it says on the go cleansing spray. What is getting cleansed exactly? So as a product, it was very gimmicky and I did not find the whole purpose of this product. So which is why this definitely makes it in my disappointments. Next product I have from Pixi, another brand I really, really enjoy. And in fact, the Glow range from this brand is my absolute favorite. But this particular product from their Glow range, that is their Glow Tonic Cleansing Gel, is an absolute miss from my side. I mean, this is a cleanser. It's an exfoliating cleanser, but does absolutely nothing for my skin. This does not even foam up. So, aisa lagta bhi nahi ki chehra saaf ho raha hai. Matlab, aisa kuch nahi lagta hai. Kuch aisa, after that also, I feel like mujhe koi aur face wash use karna hai, because mera chehra saaf nahi lag raha hai. So, that is why I don't enjoy using this. I know it's a chemical exfoliant, it's soap free, so it's not supposed to lather up a lot, but I honestly speaking, I don't enjoy such face washes that don't lather up, because wo maza nahi aata hai, muh dhone ka maza nahi aata hai, okay? Like it did nothing, honestly did nothing, and it's a very expensive face wash. Especially when it comes to India, it becomes even more expensive, so I didn't like this. Next product I want to talk about is by Mamaearth. This is their Bye Bye Blemishes face cream, and nothing. I mean, I want to say bye bye to this product. I mean, what did it even do? It literally feels like a cold cream, kuch bhi, no blemishes got vanished with this. In fact, I have so many blemishes right now, and I wanted this to do something, but this did absolutely nothing for my skin. It's a gimmick, this product. It says it has vitamin C, it's for uneven skin tone, it has bioactives. The ingredients sounded very promising, but the product in itself was very disappointing, because it did absolutely nothing for my skin. It must have just moisturized my skin, that's about it. Matlab aur kuch bhi nahi kiya. You get very little product, and it is for 500. It's a little pricier for them as well because you're getting very little product. So this product is a gimmick. Next product I have for y'all is the video that got the most hate on my channel, and that is the Minimalist AHA BHA Peeling Solution. I did a review on this where I said that this did not suit my skin. It burned my skin. In fact, it gave me a chemical reaction. And oh my god, the hate I got. People were like, you need to chemically exfoliate. Your skin should be used to it. And this, अरे यार वो वीडियो पूरा तो देखो. आई हैव सेड इन द वीडियो ओनली कि आई एम केमिकली एक्सफोलिएटिंग लिटरली ऑन अ वीकली बेसिस. माय स्किन इज वेरी यूज्ड टू इट. आई इनफैक्ट इवन गो टू द डर्मेट एंड गेट केमिकल पील्स डन. मतलब क्या चाहते क्या हो मेरे से. दिस प्रोडक्ट फॉर अ लॉट ऑफ रीजंस व्हिच आई ऑलरेडी सेड इन द वीडियो वाज नॉट ओके विथ मी. Like, forget the packaging, okay? Like, just forget about it. People were coming at me, ke, why don't you call out Dot & Key for their packaging? Arre, Dot & Key ko ka maine video review kiya hai kya unke products? Minimalist ke review video mein, how can I name Dot & Key and say ki unka packaging bhi galat hai? Arre, I'm talking about, aise to bahut log hai jinhonne packaging copy kiya hai and ek ek ko hum review karenge. But for that video, it was Minimalist na. That video ke comments are hilarious to me at this point because people don't even watch the whole video and they just want to like, oh, and come at me in the comments. So to each one's own, but this product did not suit me, okay? This is a peeling solution. I have used the Ordinary AHA BHA. I have used a lot of good peeling solutions from Dr. Shades, from Ordinary, from Pixi and all of that. And everything has suited my, never have I ever got a burning reaction from a peel, okay? So this product for that very reason did not suit me. I could not use it and I really questioned the stability of this product. And yes, one thing I mentioned wrong in the video, which I corrected in the description box as well as in the comments, was that I thought that this is now saying AHA BHA and then now on the website there is no product as such and now they've added PHA. So I thought that it is the same product, but it's not. They have stabilized apparently and come up with a new launch and they don't retail this anymore. So they've just stabilized this. But like, dude, a lot of people must have bought it initially also, right? So what do I do of this bottle? What do I do of the money I put behind this bottle? This was not PR or anything. Free mein thode aaya hai. 600 rupiah dala hai maine is pe. To kya karu main abhi iska? Matlab, you know, and all of this firstly to gets expired in literally a year's time. Secondly, it's not suiting me. It was my money down the drain. I did not have a good experience. And whenever I don't have a good experience or have a good experience, I make sure to share it on my channel. So that's what I did. I never said in that video that I don't trust Minimalist as a brand or anything. In fact, last time I bola bhi ki if you all want me to try anything else from them, I will do that also. Meri skin ko risk karke, I will do that also. So a lot of people said a lot of other things are really good from them. Try this, try that, do this, do that. हाँ तो ठीक है, आई विल आगे जाके आई विल बाय मोर थिंग्स फ्रॉम देम एंड रिव्यू. मुझे Minimalist से कुछ इशू नहीं है. आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू पॉइंट आउट थिंग्स दैट आई फेल्ट वर अ लिटिल शेडी अबाउट देम. दैट्स व्हाट आई डिड एंड दिस प्रोडक्ट डिड नॉट वर्क फॉर मी. दैट्स व्हाट आई एम सेइंग. So yeah, this was the next product in the worst of 2020. Next, we have this particular face scrub come pack from Myoho Pure by Priyanka. This is their apricot face scrub. When I reviewed them in a dedicated video, also I said that this particular face pack I don't like for multiple reasons. Firstly, the smell of this is very annoying to the point that I can't even open this and it will be very, very like strong. And secondly, it has like scrub beads, like very harsh walnut type of, like it's apricot. So it's apricot scrub beads, which can be really harsh on your skin, especially when you apply it all over your face. So don't ever do that. I only apply it on my T-zone and even there I feel it's a little too coarse. The fragrance is such that I don't even find it like usable because of the fragrance and it breaks me out. So because of multiple reasons, this did not work out for me. So yeah, it makes it to my worst list. Next product from Pure by Priyanka that I did not like is the Rose Blush Face Mask. Now this mask, I don't have anything bad to say. Aisa kuch bura nahi hai. It's just that kuch achha bhi nahi hai. Matlab, it's a very so-so product. It's pretty much a gimmick because it says it has clay and calamine and it's basically supposed to be calming clay mask. So it's for your irritated skin. So even when my skin is irritated, it doesn't really help that much. And also because it's 900 rupees, that's a lot of money for a clay mask. There are really good affordable clay masks that do a lot more for my skin, which is why this makes it to the worst of 2020. Since we are on face masks, I want to talk about this company and this particular product. This is Banish Acne Scars is the name of the company. They had actually reached out to me long ago, like when I had started my channel, and sent me a bunch of their products. To be very honest, as a brand, overall only their products I found very underwhelming. In fact, I had so many, like, bahut sare products the unse. Kuch bhi aisa nahi laga ki, wow, you know, iske baare mein baat karte hai. Like, wow, ye hi use karna hai. Like, you know, sometimes you use a product and you're like, isko chhodna hi nahi hai. Like, how I feel about the Body Shop serum, like, wo chhodna hi nahi hai, wo hamesha use karungi main. I did not find any product from their brand just me I felt that way. And this particular product was absolute shit. Like, this is the activated charcoal face mask. Firstly, it's in a powder form, okay? It's like powdered and you have to put water and activate it and then apply it. No matter how much water you put, like even if you put one drop, it's going to be the most runniest consistency. Wo thick paste banta hi nahi hai ye face mask ka. Like the clay mask has to be thoda gaada na, to wo lage to then you feel that satisfactory feeling of putting a clay mask, then wo hard ho jata hai and then you wash it off. It's a gimmick for a clay mask. It's not a clay mask. It basically does not even reach up to the consistency of a clay mask, and then because it's so runny and watery, it does absolutely nothing. So again, this product is a very, very stupid product overall, and I did not like it. Next, I have this product from La Organo. This is their aloe vera gel. Now, this is the most perfumed aloe vera gel I've ever used, okay? Because I use aloe vera gel. I prefer using aloe vera gels jo manufacture karke dabbe mein aata hai, even though mere ghar mein jhaad hai, because main bahut lazy hu aur wo jhaad ka patta kaato, fir usko nikalo, fir wo sab kaun karte baithega. So I prefer using jo dabbe mein aata hai, you know. So I love the Face Shop one, I love the Myoho Pure by Priyanka one, but this particular one is a little too fragrance. Like aloe vera gel mein dalna hai kya bro, gel dalo, thoda preservative dalo, bas hua na, itna fragrance dalne ki kya zarurat hai. It's smell to kuch aur hi aati hai, aloe vera gel ki smell aati nahi hai isme se, which is why I have not even used it. That's why I can't even tell you कि आई यूज इट एंड इट्स नॉट गुड. आई यूज इट वंस और ट्वाइस, ऐसा कुछ एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी नहीं है एंड बहुत फ्रेग्रेंस है, तो यू कैन स्टे अवे फ्रॉम दिस वन. इट इज इनएक्सपेंसिव, इट्स 300 rupees, बट इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग, इवन द फेस शॉप वन इज 399 और समथिंग, सो यू कैन गेट दैट वन इंस्टेड. ओके, लास्ट प्रोडक्ट फॉर स्किन केयर, आई हैव दिस लिप बाम बाय लिप स्मैकर. दिस इज देयर कोको कोला लिप बाम. सो व्हेन लिप स्मैकर केम आउट विद देयर लिप बाम्स इन इंडिया, आई वाज वेरी एक्साइटेड टू गेट माय हैंड्स ऑन देम, बट गुड, आई डिड नॉट गेट टू एक्साइटेड एंड बाय एवरीथिंग, बिकॉज आई लव दैट होल 90s वाइब दे गिव विद द कोको कोला एंड फैंटा एंड स्प्राइट लिप बाम्स, एंड दैट इज द होल एस्थेटिक ऑफ लिप स्मैकर. बट आई गॉट द कोको कोला चेरी लिप बाम. इट स्मेल्स horrible. It doesn't smell or taste. I was expecting to taste like Coca-Cola, you know, so I was like so excited ki lagaungi aur Coca-Cola taste hoga pura din, wow. Aisa kuch nahi hua, okay. It tastes like, it doesn't even smell like Coca-Cola. It's like a very, it doesn't even smell like those, wo 1 rupaye ka Pepsi peete the na, uske jaisa bhi smell hai. Like kuch ajeeb hi smell hai iska, aur taste to kuch hai hi nahi, aur fir lip balm jaise koi factors hi nahi hai, itna moisturizing to hai nahi. It's a very drying lip balm, in fact bahut dry formula hai. So overall, if you've not bought this and wasted your money, please don't buy it, because it's a very expensive, like for a lip balm that too of the quality, it's a very like flimsy packaging. I think it's 300 or something. Please save your money and don't buy this. That was all I had for skincare. Now I just have two hair care products to share with you all. When it comes to hair care, I'm not one to experiment. Baal bahut precious hai mere aur bahut kam bache hai, to sab gir gaye, to main kya karungi life ke sath. So which is why I've kept my hair safe and tried very few hair care, and usme se two things did not work for me. The first thing, I of course reviewed this in Vlogmas 2020 itself. This is the Tribe Concepts 90 Day Miracle Hair Oil. This gave me the khujli of my life. Itna baal khuja raha tha ye hair oil se, baap re, matlab खुजा खुजा के हाल हो गए थे मेरे. कुछ तो है ये हेयर ऑयल में जो इट डिन अग्री विथ मी, ओके, डिन नॉट सूट मी, डिन वर्क फॉर मी, कांट डू दिस. आई एम सॉरी फॉर एवरीबडी हु लव्स दिस, बिकॉज आई नो अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल लव दिस, बट डिन नॉट वर्क फॉर मी, आई एम सॉरी. एंड लास्टली, आई हैव द मामा अर्थ अनियन हेयर सीरम, अनदर प्रोडक्ट दैट आई फील वेरी स्ट्रांगली about. In fact, I don't feel strongly about this. I feel nothing about this. Kuch nahi kiya. Like hair serums, na, either you give me a good hair serum, I will use it once and I'll be like, yehi hai boss, yehi hai, bahut achha hai. Like the L'Oreal one. Like I used it once and I was like, too good. Like I'm only using this now, and that is what I'm doing. I love the L'Oreal serum. This hair serum, I used it once, I used it twice, I used it thrice. Didn't control my frizz, didn't do anything for my hair. Does not feel like anything. It feels like a very watery texture. And does not control my frizz. In fact, like that's the main thing that I need my hair serum for. Like control my frizz, that is all I'm asking from you. Not doing that, can't do anything about it. It says it's for strong frizz-free hair. Don't know about strong, but definitely not frizz-free. And with that, we complete today's video. These were all of the skincare and hair care products that disappointed me in the year 2020. Let me know in the comment section if you had any of these products and they disappointed you too. or if there are any other products that disappointed you this year, so I will stay clear of them next year. If you did actually like today's video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. For today's video, the Sara Squad shout out goes to Brishika Chhetri. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video Sara Squad shout out, all you gotta do is hit the subscribe button, the bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sara Squad, and you get a chance to be a part of my next video Sara Squad shout out. I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, take care, I love you. Mwah.